For my first trick, pulling the dog out of the hat. Thank you, Chippy. Now for some credits. Impressed, eh? Well, watch this. Let me try that again. The wand never fails. I'm getting the idea, and now for my next trick. Oh well, back to the old drawing board. Pretty good, huh? I'm entirely self-taught, you know. I can't believe you've watched this far. I would have skipped through it by now. I can smell burning. Hang on.
Ow! Ow! Ooh! Ow! Ooh!
I'd like to see you do better. I wonder if I can find a better dog in here. Wow! I didn't even have time to get a phone number. And now, for all you traditionalists... knocks them dead every time. Now for the woman again. Never mind, I like a woman with spirit. This homework is really bugging me. I think I'll find the dog and put it in the dryer again. So that's where you are. What's this? Ye oldie spell bookie. What a load of old rubbish.
Okay, Gobbos, this magic paper bring food. I thought I heard something. Palaziggy. Palazangi. Palazongi. Palazongi. Meat on him. Down food. Need more pepper.
Dear Simon, I am pleased to announce that you have been chosen from literally hundreds of hopeful candidates to perform a death-defying but extremely worthwhile quest, for which you will be rewarded quite a lot. All you have to do is rescue me from the hands of the evil sorcerer Sordid. Feel free to use my extremely valuable spellbook and dog to assist you. Look forward to seeing you soon. Wish you were here. Love and kisses. Calypso, Grand High Wizard of the Village of Fleur de Lis. P.S. Before you can use the spellbook, you must become a wizard. There are some wizards hanging around in the local tavern who can help you. PPS, use this magic postcard and map to help you. Oh, great. I'm stuck here in this stinking world in these stinking clothes and not a pizza bar in sight. Lucky this is just a dream or I'd be really worried. It's a fine example of its kind. There's a pair of scissors in here. It must be Calypso's junk. A strange picture with strange symbols around it. It's my little dog, Chippy. It's a fine example of its kind. No one will miss this old thing. He's very muscular. Good morning. He's too engrossed in his work to hear me. It's a metal bar from inside a bell. Large, wooden, and completely locked. Psst. Did you say... Psst?
Hey, me? Yes.
What do you want?
You interested in any... Priceless antique porcelain figurines?
Not really.
They're handcrafted by the ancient ones of Grohl.
No thanks.
I've got lots of other priceless antiques. Anyone for gold piece?
How come you can sell priceless antiques for so little?
It's the recession. I've got lots of one-off bargains.
Have you got any hint books for this game?
Sorry, sold the last one 5 minutes ago. I've got lots of other stuff though.
Let's have a look then.
Anything on the mat is yours for only one gold piece. See anything takes your fancy?
No, but I've got something that might take yours.
Really? Let's have a look then. Don't waste my time. Now, is there anything you want or not?
Have you got any dodgy salesman repellent?
Sold out, just last week. Is there anything else you want?
Well, have you got any magical stuff?
But of course I have. For the right price. Firstly, there's a strength potion. Watch. Do genuine, long-lasting, fast-acting strength potion, yours for only 10 gold pieces. Alright, 5 gold pieces.
Well...
3 gold pieces then? But that's the last I go, what do you say?
I've changed my mind about magical stuff.
That was the last of it anyway. Do you see anything else interest you?
No, all the rest is junk. Goodbye.
Who needs your custom anyway?
I love wagon wheels. You can go up it or down it. It's super-powered elephant cold remedy. It's a specimen collecting jar for invertebrates. Papier-mâché moose head. It's too big for me. I wonder what this is doing here. I haven't got any quarters. It's a box of safety latches. He looks completely out of it. A jolly looking barman. Good morrow, barkeep.
Good morrow, lad.
Do you know where Calypso has got to?
Nah, but then that old geezer is always going off without telling anybody. Collecting magical ingredients, he says. Who knows what sort of harm could befall him, especially with that Sordid character running about.
What do you know about Sordid?
Very little. He lives up in the craggy peaks and generally keeps himself to himself. He's boosted my trade tenfold, though.
How is Sordid helping to boost business?
It's a long story. Apparently, he wants to take over the entire world using black magic. Anyway, as a result, all the heroes are donning rusty armor again and coming back into service, all of them seeing themselves as the saviors of the world. The thing is, though, they all stop here for a drink on the way. I've seen all sorts go through here. Warriors, wizards, priests, assassins, and not one has been seen again.
So what?
I don't see what all the fuss is about personally. So he may be a bit power crazy and all that, but who isn't these days? Old fella keeps himself to himself. He don't bother us, we don't bother him, and that's that.
I come from another dimension.
As I said, we get all sorts in here.
You talk a lot, don't you?
I'm a bartender. The punters expect local gossip and general small talk from me.
I quite fancy a drink now. Make mine a wet wizard.
Hang on a moment. I'm sure I've got some sparrow juice down here somewhere. Where is it? What's that stupid man done with it? I'm sorry, sir, I can't seem to find any sparrow juice at the moment.
That's okay, I'm underage anyway.
Anything else, sir?
How about a warlock surprise?
Hang on a moment. I'm sure I've got some essence of fruit back down here somewhere. Where is it? Oh, Helen Buckshot. I'm sorry, sir, I can't seem to find any essence of fruit bat at the moment.
That's okay, I'm underage anyway.
Anything else, sir?
Nice talking to you. So long.
See ya.
I'm looking. Hello. So, do you come here often?
What are you on, kiddo? Get out of here.
This thorn, I got it stuck in my foot and I can't get it out.
Let's have a look at it then. Soon have this out. It might sting a bit.
Ow!
There we are, all done.
Thank you so much. I'm forever in your debt.
Think nothing of it.
Okay, but here. Take this whistle. If you ever need any help, just blow it and I'll be there.
Thanks. What a nice guy. doesn't look very wise.
Excuse me, boy?
Yeah?
I can't quite remember. Never mind.
Right.
Excuse me.
Excuse me. Have you remembered what it was you wanted yet?
Wanted? Did I want something?
Yes.
What, did I want?
I don't know. You couldn't remember.
Nonsense. I can,
remember?
Remember everything. I'm, wise owl. I'm just not very good with,
words?
Words, yes.
Have you got any hints for me?
Hints? Yes. You must be...
handsome?
No.
Suave?
No, no. Your name?
Simon?
That's it? Yes.
How did you know my name?
The, stars told me. I'm an,
idiot?
No.
Owl?
No. Stars thingy.
Astrologer?
Yes, astrologer. Yes.
Go on then, what's my future?
Future? Yes, future. I have some, advice.
Yes?
Brush your teeth after, every, meal.
Is that all?
For the, moment, yes.
Great.
Come back,
later?
Yes,
I don't think I'll bother, thanks. It's a feather.
says, caution, paleontological dig in process.
Only.
I am a dwarf.
Course you are. Now sod off, or taste the sharp end of your spear.
Nice people. It's a rock. Oh, look. There's a word written on it. It has the word beer chalked on it. He's assaying the gems from the mine. Watch ya, fella dwarf.
Go away, I'm busy.
What's rattled your cage?
You, now go away.
I'm an inspector from head office.
Where's your ID?
I've left it at home.
Leave me alone.
He appears to be asleep. Excuse me. Hello! Wow, heavy sleeper. He seems to be in a drunken stupor.
Anyone for a beer?
He looks very drunk. He looks drunk. He probably couldn't tell his arse from his elbow. They are beer barrels. It's a pile of empty beer bottles. He seems to be in a drunken stupor. It's not a Yale.
Anyone for a beer?
I'm not wandering around wearing this beard. It's too itchy. Ah, that's better. There's a piece of paper under this rock. Thank you. address to the storekeeper in town. It's a sturdy wooden door.
The asparagus jelly goes here with all the other jellies.
Yeah, I disagree. It should be put here with the other vegetables.
I say it goes here.
And I say it goes here.
Okay, but I need to go to the toilet.
No way. You'll have to restrain yourself.
Look! This is my body as much as it is yours.
No, it isn't. I was here first. You just sprouted out of my shoulder.
Who shouldn't have been mucking about with glowing rocks then?
Shut up.
I need the toilet.
Ask nicely.
Can we go to the toilet, please?
No.
I'll remember this, you know.
Was it you that put the organic soup here?
It goes better with all the other soups.
But it's organic, so it goes with the...
Excuse me?
You're not the regular person.
He's sick.
No. Okay then. Tell the delivery boy we'll leave it outside when we've finished making it up.
Okie dokie. Excuse me? How do, boys? What's new?
Not a lot. He's a little uglier, perhaps.
And he's a little stupider.
See you around.
Bye.
This magical map is used to speed around the game.
I'll have to sell everything. I should have known this would happen.
He looks miserable. Excuse me?
Yeah?
Down on your luck, mate.
Very observant.
You look like you need cheering up.
No one can cheer me up. My life is in ruins.
Nonsense. It's never too late to be of good cheer.
That's easy for you to say. What did I do to deserve this?
What exactly is the problem?
Trees.
Trees? Big hard brown things with green bits?
Trees, yes.
How can a tree be a problem?
It's not all trees, just the ones around here.
What's so special about these trees?
They have some sort of magical protection over them. The blows of my axe just bounce off.
Why don't you just go back to a normal forest?
Because all my money is tied up in this house, I can't afford to go back. It looked like a real woodcutter's paradise in the brochure. Now I know why none of the others came here.
Collax.
Do you know how much those things cost? The only thing that'll help me is an axe made of Milrith.
Milrith?
It's an anagram of Mithril. It's also the hardest metal known to man.
I'll keep an eye out for some for you.
Then you'll be looking for a long time. It's incredibly rare, and I don't know anyone that's ever seen it.
Have you tried the dwarves?
If you want mithril, dwarves is fine, but those stunty buggers don't know anything about Melrith. When I asked, all they did was give me this metal detector.
Give me the metal detector and I'll have a look round.
Okay. You can't do any worse than me, I suppose.
You're on.
What shall I do?
Did you just hear something?
Just a bit of balsa, or plywood. We're not fussy.
I must be hearing things. I could have sworn I heard a voice. I think I need to sit down.
Get off me! I could on your feet under there. My whole life flashed before my eyes.
There has to be some sort of logical explanation for this.
You can at least look at me when you're talking to me. Just because I'm begging doesn't mean I'm a bad person.
I was talking to the player, not you.
Oh, right. So, you got any spare wood or not?
I'd give you wood if I could, but I can't, so I won't.
Oh, you couldn't do a woodworm a favour, could you?
Woodworm?
Of course. You didn't honestly think you were talking to a tree stump, did you?
No, of course not.
That's all right then.
How come you woodworm are talking anyway?
That's just so typical. You just presume we don't talk, just because we're woodworm. Let me tell you something, mate. Your attitude is bloody typical of humanity in general. It makes me sick. You never talk to us. You just presume that woodworm can't talk. It's just racism to the third degree.
Look, I didn't mean to offend anyone.
That's what they all say. One misplaced foot and 10 of my best friends never breathe again.
I'm sorry, okay? How can I make it up to you?
Well, what we would really like is some really good quality wood. Something with real class. Teak, for example.
Or go for wood.
I reckon driftwood.
Driftwood? How about a bit of ebony?
Ebony, yeah. What about balsa? I love a bit of balsa.
Ebony! Balsa! Ebony!
Driftwood!
Yeah!
Shut up yourself, fatso!
Fatso? Look who's talking, blubberbum!
Young hooligan, have some respect!
Shut up, Griffin!
I reckon it should be oak.
And I say balsa.
I still agree with Teak.
Who cares what you think?
Watch it, mate, or I'll do you an injury.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah! It's been ages since we had gopher wood.
It's been ages since we had any wood.
Teak!
Balsa!
Oak!
Mahogany!
Good idea!
I fancy a bit of mahogany.
Yeah!
I still prefer teak.
Shut up!
Mahogany it is, then.
I'll just go and get some then.
You won't regret this, you know.
A sturdy wooden door. I'd better knock. Nobody home. The handle to wind the rope up. It's a very deep well. It's a fine example of a bucket of water.
It's only me, the littlest billy goat Gruff. I'm going to the meadow to make myself fat.
Then I'm gonna gobble you up.
Oh no, please don't gobble me up. I'm far too little and not at all fat. Wait until the second billy goat Gruff comes along. He's much fatter than I am.
Very well, be off with... Hang on a minute. I've fallen for this before. If we keep going on like this, then I get flooded into the river. Again.
No, no, no! That's all wrong. Referring you to page 23 of the text, I say the he's much fatter than I am bit, at which point you say, very well, be off with you. And then you wait for the second billy goat Gruff and so on. It's that easy.
Listen, Mr. Gruff. Every day I get knocked into the bloody river and I'm fed up with it. I'm starving. Therefore, contrary to popular children's tale, I'm going to eat you. And pop your friend there in the court.
Now come on, Mr. Troll. You signed the contract for this job, so say a bit and let me past, or start cleaning out your office.
Let me tell you something. I don't care for this job or the office. In fact, I'm about to terminate my contract with the Gruff, Gruff & Gruff Corporation by eating one of my employers.
Can't we be reasonable here? It doesn't make sound economic sense for you to do that. Why don't we talk this over like civilized adults?
Survival of the fittest, I'm afraid, Mr. Gruff. Let's examine basic survival instincts for a moment. I'm a big, powerful carnivore, and you are a weak, defenseless herbivore. By rights, I should be currently cleaning your remains out of my teeth.
Referring you once again to the text, you will observe that by refraining from eating me, you will have the opportunity to devour my somewhat larger brother over there.
Mr. Gruff, you've always been a considerate employer. I've always had my Christmas bonus, etc. So I've decided not to eat you, but to take industrial action instead. I'm forming a picket line. No one may cross the bridge until further notice.
He's stopping anyone from crossing the bridge.
I shall not be moved.
The billy goat is trying to reason with the troll.
I shall not...
Ahem. Look, can't you see I'm busy?
What appears to be the problem here?
I demand satisfaction, and until I get it, no one may cross the bridge.
What do you want?
I told you. Satisfaction, whatever that is.
Why are you unhappy?
Every day these juicy, fat billy goats come down here across the bridge. I know how the story goes and all that, but I'm dying of starvation. Until I get a goat to eat, no one may cross the bridge.
Why don't you just eat these two now?
These two are protected. their big brother is a fleet hut customer, you know. Believe me, I should know. If I lay a claw on them, then...
You're scared of a billy goat.
This is no ordinary billy goat. He's 12 feet long and horns like you've never seen. All I want is some goat to eat.
Fine. I'll go get some goat for you, okay?
Okay. Hang on a minute. What's with the whistle around your neck?
It's a magic whistle.
Magic, eh? Give it here. That did a lot. Now, where were we? Oh, yeah. I was just going to suggest eating you in.
Is this guy bothering you?
Yeah, sick him.
Righty-ho.
Oh.
You've been picking on my friend.
No,
he seems to think otherwise.
Ow.
What should I do with him?
Chuck him in the stream.
Okie dokie. Everything okay now?
Yeah, thanks a lot.
See ya.
Doesn't look very intelligent. What appears to be the problem?
Are you a farmer?
Do I look like a farmer?
No, but you could be wearing a costume.
I see.
Know anything about magic beans?
What beans?
Magic beans. I've swapped them for a cow with a peddler. He said they were magic beans and would lead to fortune and glory.
And?
I planted them there, but they haven't grown an inch yet.
Maybe they're dud beans.
They can't be. They came from the same batch as the ones that Jack used.
Maybe you should water them.
Water them? Why would I want to do that?
To make them grow?
That sounds like a good idea. I'll tell you what. You go and get the water, and I'll keep watch.
I'm one step ahead of you, mate.
Well, don't just stand there then. Pour it on the seeds. You drown them. I have to go and dry them out now.
I think this is my cue to exit.
Thank you.
A heap of highly magical and smelly compost. Wow, this must be good compost. Big, green and fruity. That would completely overpower my pheromones.
I do beg your pardon.
Thank you.
How can I help you?
You can't. I'm just passing through.
Oh.
I'm not staying here with that racket going on.
Oh, curses. It's broken.
This is your lucky day. I just happen to own a musical instrument repair parlor. I can have it done up for you in no time.
Really?
Sure. Just hand it over and I'll return it within an hour. It's a door set into an old tree. I'd better knock. Anybody home?
Hello?
Huh?
Oh, it is so nice to have Persian come visit me. I is so pleased.
Are you some sort of boggy person?
Not a boggy person. I's one and only Swampling, the bestest cook in the land. People come for around miles to eat swamp stew.
But it smells revolting. Let me out of here before I chuck up.
Wow! I thought you were my first birthday friend. I thought you'd come to play with me for my birthday. No one ever comes to see me anymore.
Oh, don't cry. I've come to see you.
Sit! Sit! I bring special birthday stew.
Hang on, I didn't agree to...
Friend! I give my friend special swamp stew. Ancient and secret recipe, handed down from Swamplin to Swamplin for generations.
Okay, I'll give it a whirl.
I'm very pleased with this batch. Extra woodlouse works well.
I wish this was happening to you instead of me.
I think I hear someone. I think some more friends have arrived. No one there. I hope you like it. Plenty more for friend.
Okay, just one more bowlful.
Eat up. It's good for you.
Oh, no.
I hope you like it. Plenty more for friends.
Okay, just one more bowlful.
Eat up! It's good for you!
Oh, no. Not again! God, I won't have to eat any more of that stuff. Strike up an intelligent conversation with an inanimate object.
bizarre creature. Excuse me?
Yes? Don't hurt us. Don't let him hurt us, precious nice hobbits.
I hope this isn't an infringement of copyright.
Don't worry. It's just the annual meeting of the Tolkien Appreciation Society.
What's with the fishing rod?
It's like this. Every year one of us gets chosen to get lunch. I haven't had so much as a nibble yet.
Luckily, I happen to have some top quality, highly nutritious swamp stew with me.
Really? That's excellent. Will this go around 40 people?
It's concentrated. Just add boiling water and stir.
Thanks a lot. You can have the fishing rod in return.
Ta.
I'll go and join the others looking for the ring.
What ring?
The ring. I could have sworn I had it on me when I started fishing.
It's a very imposing door. It's a shiny metal bell. Peroxide blonde.
What the hell do you want? You're not the Wicked Witch.
I've come to rescue you, sweet lady.
You're not the first. The witch caught the rest of them and turned them into meat pate.
Which witch would that be?
The Wicked Witch of the West. She took me from my father when I was just a piglet. It was she that perverted my beauty and imprisoned me here. Am I destined to spin wool for the rest of eternity?
You still look damn stunning to me.
You have only seen half of it.
My God!
Everyone makes the same mistake. And when they see my face, they run screaming from the tower. The only way the spell can be broken is with a kiss from one from another dimension.
This is where I come in, I feel. Fear not, your savior is here. What did I do to deserve this? It's a box of groceries for the goblins. It's dark in here. Lucky I'm only small. I wonder when we'll get there. I'd better put the ring on now. Well, either I can still see myself, or the ring needs recharging. Hang on a moment. Oh, I had it on backwards. There are loads of empty cardboard boxes. My spell book's in this one. I wonder where the rest of the rat is. My spell book's in this box. I finally got my spellbook back. There's a loose piece of paper in it. It's a metal slops bucket with a hole in the side of it. It's a packet of super extra strong mints. Thank you. manacled to the rack. Are you the druid from the village?
Who art thou that hast voice but no presence?
I'm wearing a ring of invisibility.
Do not joke with me, Hellspawn. Yes, I'm the village druid, and you are in league with the hordes of darkness.
What makes you think that?
I can smell the unnaturalness about you like a foul odor. Begone, Prince of Darkness!
Look, let's be reasonable for a moment.
I shall listen to no more lies from you. Leave now, or suffer the consequences.
I'm sorry I spoke, okay? Goodbye.
Deceiveth me, or 'tis a young boy in this den of filth.
See? I told you I wasn't evil.
Fie! 'Tis you, demon prince. Thou shalt not fool me with thy disguise.
How can I prove I'm innocent?
There is a simple test.
What is this simple test?
It is a well-known fact that the only true way to destroy a demon is to plunge a silver dagger through its heart. If the creature dies, then it's a demon. If it lives, then its heart is pure, and so we sacrifice it.
I expect you find a lot of demons by this method.
Never been wrong yet.
Isn't there a slightly less painful trial?
Aha! Afraid, creature of the night?
To be perfectly honest, I am just a tad.
Okay, let's use the less reliable but more convenient trial. See this silver cross around my neck? Base it against your forehead.
Okay. Let's do it.
Very well.
Goodbye, cruel world.
Yow! So, you are a servant of evil. Did you enjoy the feel of the burning hot fire of good?
What? That thing was freezing cold. Gave me quite a shock.
Oh, well, I suppose I'd better take it all back then.
Jeez.
So, what's the escape plan then?
Well, I don't know. Got any bright ideas?
Well, let me see. Are you any good with a sword?
No.
Can you cast powerful spells?
Yeah, no.
Looks like we're stuck then.
Unless, of course, you can use some special druidic power to free us.
It's not as easy as that. Flower... druidic magic comes from nature. All I can do without some nature handy is polymorph.
Poly what?
All druids are capable of turning into another animal. It happens when they see a full moon.
I can't see any way of getting a full moon in here.
It doesn't have to be a full moon. It just has to look like one.
What are you then?
A frog.
A frog?
Something wrong with that, is there?
No, no, no. But a frog.
I can't help it. It was chosen for me by the head of the order.
Well, I'm sure that'll be of some use. Can I please put this bucket on your head?
Why? Do you have some sort of plan?
Yes, I've got a plan. Thank you.
my hat is fireproofed. I'd better hide until he gets back with help. I'll put the ring back on. I must have run the batteries out.
You'd better get others.
Oh dear.
Maybe, beep.
A standard instrument of torture.
Why not go in there?
You go! Ow! Extreme acupuncture. I think my hay fever's cured them.
I'm coming now, so watch it. Aha! I can't see no one. No. No one in here.
In behind you.
What? Ah! Not funny. You on cleaning duty for a week.
Please not, Captain. Have mercy.
I know like look of things. We go get more gobos.
I third that, Captain.
That was hot in there. I need a drink. Very strong hacksaw. I feel lucky. I'm going to do this very carefully. Wow, that sure is strong metal. I've already found the mill rift.
says, warning, spontaneously combustible substance.
My God! It's a real dragon!
Well, what did you expect in a dragon's cave?
This isn't happening.
I wouldn't hang about if I were you. I've got a fearful cold and consequently am not fully in control of my breath. Achoo!
Lucky I was wearing my asbestos underwear. It's a carbon dioxide fire extinguisher. My, that's an interesting rock. It has a fossil in the middle of it. She's asleep on the floor. Just like Granny used to have. I suppose it's the equivalent of a giant joint for bees. It's all laid and ready for tea. It's too big for me. It's a beekeeper's hat and fashion accessory. Looks very comfortable. All the bees are stoned. It's too big for me. I took some beeswax from the hive. Hello again.
Yeah?
I'd like a wet wizard, please.
Hang on a moment.
It's a lump of sticky yellow wax from the beehive.
I'm sure I've got some sparrow juice down here somewhere.
I've blocked the nozzle on the barrel with the wax.
I'm sorry, sir, I can't seem to find any sparrow juice at the moment.
That's okay, I'm underage anyway.
Wait here, kid, I've got something for you. Hey, kid, take one of these leaflets home to your dad.
Happy hour at the Drunken Druid. Ale for one gold piece a mug. There's also a free beer voucher attached. There's enough beer in this barrel for a really good night with the lads. Good thing I've got a big hat. Sophisticated. Itchy, though.
All right, mate.
All right.
What's the password, then?
Is it beer?
You may pass.
Right on. Care for some beer, by any chance?
I'm on duty, but I suppose one mag can't hurt. Bring it down, will you?
Okie dokie.
This way. Bring it over here. Now, how about a drinking competition?
Anyone for a beer? Guard? Guard? Time for a sharp exit. Where is that lazy slug? He must have gone for a beer break.
Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to a we go. La 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 la
la la
Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to a we go. La 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 la.
It's a broken tattoo along the road. It's a heavy gold-encrusted door.
Shut up!
Hi-ho, hi-ho.
That doesn't work.
Shut up!
That doesn't work.
Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to where we go. La 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 la.
Shut up!
Oi! Get out of here! This is a restricted area.
I've come to make you an offer.
Really? What sort of an offer? What's this? Happy hour at the Drunken Druid and a free voucher? How can I ever repay you?
Nice pile of gems you got there.
Just one, though. Here you are. Now clear off. And stay out.
Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to where we go. La 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 la. Ow, 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 ow.
I'm not wandering around wearing this beard. It's too itchy. Better? Catch!
I don't believe it! This is an extremely lucky find indeed. It's an amoeba from the Cambrian period. This could be it.
Will I be as famous as you for this?
Of course, of course. Just tell me where you found this specimen, my boy.
It's in the craggy peaks. I left my metal detector there.
Excellent. I shall journey there immediately. Let me just get my things together. just tell me where you found this specimen?
A priceless gem?
Give here. I'll have a look at it. This is nice. Very nice. Dwarven, I'll wager. It's one of those gems that changes colour. I'll give you 4 pieces for it.
Don't make me laugh. I want at least 40.
40 gold pieces? I won't get any higher than 10.
It's an improvement, but still daylight robbery.
Okay, 15 pieces, but only because I like the look of you.
Sorry, I promised my associates I would get at least 20.
Okay. 18 gold pieces it is.
Pardon?
20 then. But drive a hard bargain, no mistake. I better go and put it somewhere safe. Bye.
I wonder how he did that.
The asparagus jelly goes here with all the other jellies.
Yeah, I disagree. It should be put here with the other vegetables.
I say it goes here.
And I say it goes here.
Okay, but I need to go to the toilet.
They are squares of chocolate cake.
No way. You'll have to restrain yourself.
Look!
I would like to buy this.
That will be 2 gold pieces.
Okay. Here you are.
It comes with a free nail.
Anything else, sir?
I just like to browse. I would like to buy this.
That will be 1 gold piece.
Okay, here you are.
Anything else, sir?
I just like to browse. This magical map is used to speed around the game. It's an empty wooden chest. Loose.
special herb with strange properties. Fine example of its kind. I can see the dragon's treasure down there. This is silly. Everyone knows gold isn't magnetic.
I've broken my shovel. How am I going to get out of this hole? I hit that kid. Oh dear. Yeah. I forgot my rope to get out with.
Dr. Von Jones searching for fossils. A pile of dirt excavated by Dr. Von Jones. There's also some Milrith ore here. Can you do anything with this?
I can do anything you want with such fine metal.
Good, because I need an axe head made for me.
No problem, as long as I can keep what's left over.
Sure. See you around.
To be true. Woe is, I don't believe it. Lady luck must be shining on me today. I'm off to try it out. Watch out, trees. Here I come.
A pin used as a foothold for climbing across a rock face. There's a very hot fire burning in it. I love these things. A hook used for hanging a pot over the fire. It's a block of valuable wood. I like mahogany. It's a pile of oak logs. I'm allergic to oak. I'm allergic to teak.
Yet then?
As a matter of fact, I have.
Woodworm, attack! That was wonderful! Cozy in this hat, isn't it?
I wouldn't know.
Mind if we hang around here for a while? Damn sight better than a bloody stump.
No problem.
If you need us for anything, just shout, okay?
Fine.
I think I'll catch 40 winks. See ya!
Weird. Loads of mushy novels and underwear all around here. Solid-looking wooden floorboards. Okay, boys, time for you lot to do me a favor.
No problem.
It's an engraved stone sarcophagus. How strange! It's full of bandages. I feel like a real sucker for punishment. I've got holy water, and I'm... That was a close one. Thank you.
I feel like a real sucker for punishment. That must be the Staff of Power. That was a close one. I feel like a real sucker for punishment. That must be the Staff of Power. That was a close one. I've seen this done in cartoons.
Smith, the Apothecary's Taverna, your number one for love potions, cure-alls, and it's you. Me?
That would be nice, yes.
Okay, I do have an exceedingly good potion I'm prepared to give you. However, it's a collector's item, and you must only use it as a last resort.
Okay, hand it over.
There is another condition, though.
How did I know this was coming?
If you want his fine potion, then you'll have to get me something. I need a special herb to help control my froggy condition. It's called Frog's Bane. My sources inform me that it can only be found on a place called Skull Island. If you find it, then you can have the potion. Do we have a ribbit?
Fetch, Froggy.
Rip. Thank you. I guess you want that potion now. Here you are, though I'm loath to part with it.
That's okay. I was loath to part with the frog's bane.
I see.
Strange eyes gave it to us, remember?
They think they're disguised as yokels.
Well, we didn't have to pay for it.
A nice man, though, as I recall.
Very clever with his, walk.
Excuse me?
Yes, boy?
I'm looking for some wizards. Know where I can find some?
I ain't be seeing any round these parts, like. We be us humble farmers who are.
Who are, that be right. I be about as magical as a run of bean, like.
You have absolutely feeble accents, fellas.
Are you saying we be fakes, like?
Yep.
What makes you think we're wizards anyway, like?
When I move my mouse pointer over you, it says wizards.
Oh, fair enough, I suppose. Disguise is off, lads. What did you want to speak to us about anyway?
Do you know anything about this sordid geezer?
We will not impart such information to you, a non-wizard. Stop wasting our time. Where did you say we were?
We're in a quaint rural village, according to the guide.
Listen to me for a second.
Yes, mate.
I'll do anything to be a wizard.
Anything? Anything. Well, you could do us a little favour. You see, all new wizards must perform a service to the circle before being, properly invested. Isn't that right, brothers?
Yeah, that's right.
Absolutely.
Hey? Just name it, and I'll do it.
It's like this, see? We would be extremely interested in acquiring a certain magical implement.
It's a magical staff rumored to be hidden in this area.
And we would like you to find it for us.
No problem.
We look forward to your return.
So I'm the East Wind, right?
Well, it appears we underestimated the Lang Brothers.
So now you make me a wizard, right?
There's just one or two formalities to clear up first. If you'll just answer these questions, for the record. Name?
Paul Daniels.
Thank you. All you have to do is pay the subscription fee, and you're a wizard.
Subscription fee?
Yes. A mere 30 gold pieces for junior members.
Ha! A piffling 30 gold pieces.
Where is it, then?
I wonder where old Calypso could be.
Yeah, odd him not being at home.
He might be out collecting ingredients.
We'll look for him in the morning. He might know something about the bloody staff.
Shush! Our mission's top secret.
There you are. 30 gold pieces in unmarked coins. Can I be a wizard now?
Well, I suppose so. By the power invested in me, I pronounce you a wizard.
That's it?
Yes.
No ceremonies?
No.
No adoring crowds, confetti, wild orgies, banners and ice cream?
Not usually, no.
Right then.
You do get a young wizard starter pack, though.
A starter pack?
Yes, it's got all kinds of goodies in it. You get a complimentary staff.
A Whiz Kid Club member badge.
A Whiz Kid quill.
Whiz Kid scroll notepaper.
The Whiz Kid multi-ingredient starter kit.
A membership card.
Your first issue of Whiz Kid magazine published quarterly.
And many other wonderful freebies.
There you are, all held in this free Whiz Kid wallet.
Thanks, I think.
Happy now?
Just answer me a few questions. Where's the door?
Over there by the door.
I've got two chows, two poles, and a comb.
Dab a bit of sulfate on it. It worked for me.
Thank you.
What are you staring at, mate?
You can talk?
Give the kid a cigar.
That's amazing.
No, it's just magic.
Speaking of which, I'm a powerful sorcerer.
Well, you must know a lot about magic then.
Do you know any magic?
Well, I've picked up the odd word or two as I went along. Can't quite remember what they do, though.
What are they?
It'll cost you, I'm afraid.
I seem to spend forever running errands for people.
Everyone's good at something.
What do you want?
See this pink splodge?
Yeah?
It's paint.
Yeah?
It means that bloody woodcutter will be coming along later to chop me down. If you can remove the paint, then I'll tell you some magic words.
Okay, sounds fair to me.
You can probably get some white spirit at the shop in the village.
Righty-ho.
Hurry up, though.
I'm on it. Your problems are solved.
I'm very grateful.
So, how about those magic words?
Okay. I don't know what they do, so be careful.
What are they?
Alakazam! Hocus Pocus! Abracadabra! And sausages.
Sausages?
Yep. Very powerful magic word is that.
I really do think I've been taken for a ride here.
At least I'm not going to be chopped down anymore.
Does anyone have any pick? I have a bad feeling about this. I steal from who I want.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You want to fight, do you? You want a wizard's duel?
Okay, I'm game.
Right, I'll make the rules. First, no vegetable or mineral, only animal. Second, no dragon. Third, no cheating. Any questions?
What do I have to do exactly?
Don't you know any magic words?
Of course I do.
You'll soon get the hang of it then. Ready?
Okay. Here goes nothing. Bam!
That's 1-0 to me!
Hocus Pocus!
That makes 1-1!
Wow! Sausages!
That's 2-1 to me!
Kabam!
A draw!
Hocus!
A draw! for the witches! Now, what about you, huh?
I'll just leave quietly, if that's okay with you.
And don't come back! Think yourself lucky I already ate!
I could have taken her. Just thought I'd let her off this once. Okay, wrinkled old hag, I'm back.
You want a rematch, huh?
Sure do. You were lucky last time.
That's good. I was having second thoughts about letting you go anyway. Ready?
Okay. I win?
Sort of.
Well, what do you know? I won. I guess I'll just take my prize and clear off then.
Now lose one, huh?
No dragons?
Did I say no dragons?
Now you come to mention it, I don't believe you did.
Well, I will give you a chance to defend yourself. Otherwise, it wouldn't be fair.
Abracadabra!
A mouse? How can you hope to defeat me with a mouse?
This must be my lucky day. Except that now I've got a terrible craving for cheese.
A mouse. Come out and fight like a mouse.
A very poor specimen. It hasn't even got any ears. Wow! Hot stuff! Just when I thought I was getting somewhere. A bit too much throttle there.
they're magically and physically sealed shut.
Oh.
There's a little crack in the door down here. Hello, boy. How did you get in here? Really? Oh, I see. Hey, put me down, you mangy mutt. What's that smell? Remind me to change your dog food when you get home. You've got a killer hairball here, boy. I'll get it for you. That was disgusting. There's a matchstick in here. I'll just pick it up. I think I'm in some sort of gigantic garden. I'll leave it here. It's too big to pick up. I can't reach them from here. That doesn't work. That doesn't work. Thank you. I've pulped them into oil. There's a little tadpole swimming in it. Oh, poo. Ah! Hey, I'm alive. But where the hell am I? Hey, I'm inside the frog. Yuck. Out of the way, or the tadpole gets it. I guess I showed him. Bye-bye, little friend. It's a magical mushroom with "eat me" written on it. It's a branch from a tree. I hope that thing is gone. Long and hard with a pointy end. Its surface is dull and tarnished. hope it's not like the one up the stairs. It's a shiny lever just waiting to be moved. There's 8 of them. Whoever he was, he had an enormous nose. I'd better pick it up first.
What do you know, Max? An intruder.
Intruder, yeah.
I bet, like, he's come to deal with Sordid.
Sordid, yeah.
Shall we, like, go and tell him?
Tell him, yeah.
We couldn't just sit there while the boss gets, you know, done over.
Done over, yeah.
Then again, we could just do our jobs and, you know, just eat the intruder, like, where he stands.
Eat him. Yeah.
Or we could just carry on with the game, just like ignore the intruder.
Ignore. Yeah.
Okay then.
Apparently it's some sort of magical metal polish. Sordid spellbook. It looks just like mine. Thank you. I can see my reflection in it. Pretty it ain't.
What's the matter? Never seen a talking mirror before? Oh, get a grip, will you?
La-dee-da, a talking mirror.
I'm actually a magical scrying mirror. I can see out of any reflective surface anywhere in the world. Just name the place and you can hear and see it as if you were there.
Show me the laboratory on the top floor, please.
What's the point? It's only just up the stairs.
I want to spy on Gerald and Max.
I can't imagine they'd be worth spying on, but okay, here goes.
Why are you, like, so nervous in front of strangers, Belch Grabbit?
Wouldn't you be with a name like Belch Grabbit?
It's not much better than Snogfundle, really.
Suppose not.
Belch Grabbit and Snogfundle. I've seen enough. Thanks for your help, Mr. Mirror.
There's like two orc's eyes and a goblin tooth beat a triple dragon. Thought not. I lose again, Max.
Again? Yeah.
What are you?
What do we look like? You're Shake, Max.
Tact prevents me from passing comment.
What we are is angry, annoyed, bothered, cross, displeased, exasperated, flustered, harassed, irritable, nettled, out of humour, peeved, piqued, put out, riled, ruffled and vexed, ain't we, Max?
Irritated, yeah.
Why are you irritated, I hear you ask?
Why are you irritated?
It doesn't matter. I can tell you're not interested in, you know, our problems. Is he, Max?
Not interested. Yeah.
Dying his smokes.
I'm afraid not.
It's all right. We've got loads, ain't we?
Loads. Yeah.
Excuse me.
Yeah?
Why do you stay here if you're dissatisfied?
We don't have any, like, choice. Sordid won't let us go.
What's with this Sordid guy anyway?
He wants to, you know, rule the universe, doesn't he?
Rule, yeah.
I blame the parents.
Parents, yeah.
Never fear, I, Simon, intend to stop him.
I hear the universe breathing a sigh of relief already.
Relief? Yeah.
Listen, kid, those statues you've seen ain't just novel at stands. They're what's left of all the great heroes that tried to, you know, stop him. He got the idea from a kiddie's book.
Is there any way to restore them?
Dunno. I suppose there must be. Dunno what it is, though. Anyway, if I were you, I'd get out of here as, like, fast as possible, while Sword is still in a bar.
Bar, yeah.
Okay, I'm scared. Show me the door.
Sorry, but, like, the only way out is through the teleporter in this room. Personally, I'm blowed if I'm gonna tell you how to use it.
Why won't you tell me?
We're demons, possible, while Sword is still in a bar.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm scared. Show me the door.
Sorry, but, like, the only way out is through the teleporter in this room. Personally, I'm blown if I'm gonna tell you how to use it.
Why Why won't you tell me?
We're demons, possible, while Sword is still in a bath.
Bath, yeah.
Okay, I'm scared. Show me the door.
Sorry, but, like, the only way out is through the teleporter in this room. Personally, I'm blown if I'm gonna tell you how to...
What makes you think I'm not a wizard, eh?
I've met a few wizards in my time, like, and they're all fat, chemical-stained, befuddled old fools.
Fools.
I can't be bothered to, like, argue. If you are a wizard, then send us back to the pit, and in return, we'll tell you how to use the teleport.
Teleport? Yeah.
Right then, I'll just go and get prepared.
I guess I'd better, like, pack my bags then.
Bags? Yeah.
It's Sordid spellbook. It looks just like mine. There's a spell here to return demons to hell. You need a double square with 8 candles, a mouse and a human skull. You also need to know the demons' true names. Hello again.
Got it sorted then.
I'll just draw a quick magic square on the floor.
Here, you can borrow my chalk.
Okay, we're all set. Let's rock.
I'm impressed. Very impressed. This might just work.
Work.
Hey, kiddo, now I'll tell you how to operate the light. Tell him, just push the red button marked self-destruct and tell the machine where you want to go. It's a one-way trip, though. You can't, like, get back without the password.
Password? Yeah.
And we don't, like, know it. Take it away, Sonny.
Okay, here goes. Zabag, Zinza, Zenog, Yarmak, Zog. Onya!
Looks like we're stuck.
Worked okay.
Talking teleport at your service. It would be my pleasure to whisk you safely and conveniently to the destination of your choice.
I've forgotten where I want to go.
Thank you for using Sparky the Talking Teleport. Please come again if you have found its service sufficiently fast and convenient. Sparky the Talking Teleport at your service. It would be my pleasure to whisk you safely and conveniently to the destination of your choice.
I've forgotten where I want to go.
Thank you for using Sparky the Talking Teleport. Please come again if you have found its service sufficiently fast and convenient.
Sordid spellbook. It looks just like mine. There's a spell here to return demons to hell. You need a double square with 8 candles, a mouse and a human skull. You also need to know the demons' true names. It tells you all about magic wands. It says that the only way a magic wand can be destroyed is to throw it into the fiery pits of Rondor.
This is Sparky the Talking Teleport at your service. It would be my pleasure to whisk you safely and conveniently to the destination of your choice.
Fiery Pits of Rondor, please.
Your selected destination is the Fiery Pits of Rondor. Please fasten seatbelts and extinguish smoking materials.
It's a pile of small pebbles. I had no idea this place was a tourist attraction.
3 years ago it wasn't. That's King Gerald for you. Have some brochures.
Visit the Fiery Pits of Rondor. An ideal family day out. See the fires of hell in full effect. And remember, free sunblock for everyone. Sounds really neat. So, why is there no one here?
That's just it, isn't it? The place is at least 150 miles from the nearest village. And the only way to get here is on foot or by magic. We've only had 2 visitors in the last 3 years. And one was a wizard.
Sordid?
Yeah, that's it. The other was this little green fella. Now, are you going to pay up or not?
No.
Then you aren't coming in.
It looks absolutely awful to me anyway. Oh look, there's an elastic band around them.
Person that set off the sprinkler system, I'll roast them alive. Now, I've got to find a way to relight this damn thing. Just when I was about to finish my new wand as well. That one should have worked.
Quite ironic, wouldn't you say? Hey, slime bucket! Pasta la pizza, baby!
No!
That'll teach you to mess with Simon the Sorcerer. The only problem now is how to destroy the wand and save Calypso. Sordid and all his magic couldn't get this thing working? And you expect me to be able to do it with a book of matches? Here goes. Now all the statues should return to normal. I'll be made a hero for sure. Not only have I rid the world of Sordid, but I've saved all the good guys as well. At least I'm out of danger now. I've just had a thought. Uh-oh.
Well, 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 little wizard. You've made me really angry now.
Beware, evil one, or face my wrath.
Don't make me laugh, little wizard. This time, I intend to make sure you die properly and with great suffering.
I guess it's goodbye then. You almost finished the game as well.
Say your prayers, little wizard. Sordid speaking. Who? Hang on a minute. It's some life insurance people. They want to speak to you.
Hello?
Is that Simon the Sorcerer?
Speaking.
This is Calypso here. You did a great job with the wand. We've all turned back. I'm coming to rescue you. Try and stall him for a bit, okay?
Okay.
See you in a bit. Bye!
Just to tell me my life policy is cancelled.
Okay, then. Get ready for pain such as you've never imagined.
Hang on a minute.
What is it now? Why can't you just shut up and die?
Have you heard the one about the Vicar and the Mongoose?
No. Have you heard the one about the butter?
No.
I'd better not tell you. You might spread it.
Oh.
I haven't got time for jests at the moment, though. I've got far more important things to be doing. It's time for you to die. Little squirt to mess with me!
Well, what do you know? Hundreds of razor-sharp spikes, and I miss everyone. I wonder what happened to the bridge. Nice try, loser. You'll have to do better than that to beat me.
This time, I'll make sure you die. You'll never survive that one.
I'm getting good at this falling business. I could be a stuntman. You failed again, Sordy. I'm still alive.
Not for much longer, irritating pest.
Hmm. lights.
Congratulations! Well done! You finished Simon the Sorcerer. Well, Simon, what does it feel like to be a hero?
What's this guy on?
Would you like to say something to your fans? Don't miss next year's sequel.
Don't hold your breath. I'm not going through all that again. Phew. What an awful dream. I guess I must have... Looks like I've no say about the sequel.